great to be joined by Jirka and Keira. And Keira, I wonder if you can start by just introducing who you are, what you're doing, and those kinds of things.
Hello, we're the Kralovi family, and we're Crosslinks Mission Partners in the Czech Republic. This is Jirka, he's a Czech national, and I'm Keira, and I'm from the Isle of Wight, so English. We live in the east of the Czech Republic, in the part which is called Moravia, and we live in we live very near a city called Olomouc, which I think is around the fifth biggest city in the country. And in Olomouc, we're carrying out student ministry to university students at Palackého University. So we are basically evangelizing and teaching the Bible and helping them to get anchored in their faith.
So you've been there for 12 years and you have four children, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all teenagers. So,
And like all of us this year, you've been living through the pandemic and lockdown, and it's been great to hear that you're doing well. Like all of us, you're looking forward to the light at the end of the tunnel. But there's something, in this little corner of Eastern Czech Republic, Jirka, could you tell us about what it's like from a gospel ministry perspective, spiritually speaking? What is the lie of the land in the east of the Czech Republic?
Yeah, I would say there's a great not acknowledgement of Christianity at all. I don't know how to put it. Like people just have no clue what the gospel is about, what Christianity really is about. So they got really twisted or misunderstanding, you know. So I just would give you an example. I just talk to students often. I just go in front of like this kind of student dining room, big one, where there's loads of people, lots of students walking. And I just talk to students naturally, just giving out Bibles or anything. And I talk almost all the time with some students. I ask them simple questions. Do they know anything about Christianity, or do they understand what the message of Christianity is? And when I start talking to them, they're actually interested. When I start talking to them, they do admit, like, really soon they've got absolutely no clue, and they even become interested and start asking me questions. If I can tell them, then, you know, what is them a little bit, you know, and they really become very interested, and they got no clue. And often it's very interesting. I ask at the end, when we come to actually point that they understand the gospel really as it is, in quite a brief way, but they do understand it, then they say, ask them questions, don't you think it's good news? I respect that you just don't believe it, but don't you think it's kind of like good news? And they actually put their face like, in, you know, like, it is, actually, it is. It's a pretty common response. They look like this and they say like, yeah, it's good news.
That's great. So for 12 years, you two have been plugging away with university students, trying to introduce them to the Lord Jesus, Christianity explored, and you do this in the Czech, in the local language. And there comes a point, I guess, for people like yourselves where new opportunities may emerge. And after 12 years, it's no surprise to learn of a new opportunity for the Kralovi family in Olomouc in the Czech Republic. Jirka, first of all, maybe you could tell us a little bit about the exciting opportunities that 2021 brings that you're looking forward to sharing with us.
Yeah, so we want to continue student ministry because it is exciting itself. You can reach many people, as well as I didn't mention before. What people need is to understand Bible better. And when I do these studies with them in a systematic way, they really appreciate that. They like, suddenly the Bible, the Word of God becomes real treasure, you know, for them, and they want more. And they get excited like for other work. So basically they often want to do it themselves. They can see it, they can understand the Bible, and they start getting, it's very common actually, quite a few students, they become a lot more involved in their churches. So let's say they started to lead a youth group or I got responses from pastors. They say like, wow, well, you must be doing a good job, because these guys, they went through your ministry during the student time. They grew really much and they were really helpful, you know, in our church. So that's really, that's how it should be. And I'm really glad like that it does happen. So, I think it's not me. I think it really is the word of God. People really become to understand. And that's the power of the word of God, the power of the gospel. And, but what, for future, basically it's the same, but we're getting involved now with a church plant in Olomouc, because I was asked to help preaching there, and they really appreciated the, again, kind of, this kind of exposition, you know, on Jeremiah now, and they think it's like really exciting that they can understand Jeremiah. So we are more and more involved in that church plant. So we plan for 2021 to get heavily involved in that. And that seems to be a really good group that we kind of like click together.
So you're going to be continuing the Christianity Explored ministry with students, and you're going to be continuing to pioneer a church in Olomouc with the Silesian denomination, which is part of the, it's the kind of conservative evangelical part, subset of the Lutheran church, isn't it, in that
yeah,
part
that's
of
right,
Europe.
That's right,
and I guess Keira, for yourself, you'll be supporting Jirka, but can you sort of tell us how you're feeling about this new venture?
Well, I'm really excited because it's a chance to have some teamwork aspects to our lives, because we've been working on our own for 12 years really, so it's just been us two. So it'll be a chance to be part of something bigger, you know, and to actually make something happen that wasn't already happening, you know.
It's really exciting to hear, and I know that as Crosslinks, we're excited for you. We're looking forward to how this pans out in the next few months as you get going with it. And we're also praying that your partnerships will all be given a new lease of life with you as you develop this new ministry. And we're praying for you. We ask the Lord that he might bless this work as you go forward. So thanks very much for sharing with us today.
Thank you. And thanks for partnering us with us.